The tremendous victory. Dana Bash, let me turn to you. You know, you were up in the wee hours on TV working through all of this, this history that was made. And one thing I think it's important pointing out is that through this election cycle, Donald Trump crushed two political dynasties in the Bush family and the Clintons.
That's a really interesting point and a great way to put it, Brooke. I actually didn't think of it that specifically, but you're exactly right. In fact, somebody was joking last night that Barbara Bush had it right all along, that the country doesn't need any more Bushes or Clintons from well before
her son Jeb decided to run.
Right, but it does speak to part of the reason, a big part of the reason, it appears that Hillary Clinton didn't win. It's because of the, you know, as you were just playing from Steve Bannon, talking about the Brexit effect. That's what Donald Trump said was going to happen. That's what his campaign managers said was going to happen. And it seemed to have happened, that people in this country are just so done with, never mind the dynasties, which the Hillary Clinton presidency would have effectively been, but also just business as usual. The things just don't get done here. And one of the fascinating data points in some of the exit polls is how many people who voted for Trump either don't like him, don't think he has a, you know, don't think he has a very good character, and don't think he's a temperament to be president. I think it was somewhere in the ballpark of 20%. That's a huge number. These are people who voted for him to be president. And what it says is that they're willing to take the risk with somebody they don't like and somebody that they don't necessarily think is fit for the job because they think it would still be better than the alternative.